State Weather Bureau Pagasa warns residents in northern Luzon to remain on alert as Typhoon Hulyan continues to dump heavy rains in the region. The agency says landslides and floods may occur in several provinces. Meanwhile, three dams in Luzon are currently releasing water. Some villages are also advised to prepare for possible floods. The Philippine poll body eyes extending voter registration in several areas hit by Typhoon Hulyan. The agency is checking if some of its offices in northern Luzon and the Cordillera region were able to open today amid inclement weather. Today is the last day of voter registration for the 2025 polls. COMELEC spokesperson John Rex Laudianco, however, clarifies there will be no extension in other areas as the filing of certificate of candidacies begin tomorrow, October 1st. Filipinos are warned of a rise in politically related AI content during the election season. The ICT department says these may come in the form of deep fakes and voice phishing that could mislead voters. The agency admits current digital regulations have yet to include the use of AI. It urged voters and political parties to report misleading or fake election content.
We have the commitment of the three major social media giants, Meta, Google, which is YouTube, and TikTok, that they will assist us if we detect AI-generated misleading content. What we are actually want the social media networks to do is to label them. This is misleading. This is AI-generated. This is taken out of context. The source content cannot be verified.
The Philippines halts the import of poultry products from France on suspicion of the avian flu. An agriculture department order said the import ban covers live poultry and byproducts, among others. Now, this decision follows French authorities' confirmation of avian influenza outbreaks in three areas. The agency says the indefinite ban will seek to prevent the virus from reaching the local poultry industry. Veterinary quarantine officers were told to confiscate shipments of French wild and domestic birds. Philippine poultry imports from France amounted to 150,000 kilograms from January to August. The Philippine Migrant Workers Department says it is still awaiting confirmation from international airlines if they have resumed flights to and from Lebanon. DMW Undersecretary Bernard Olalia reveals two batches of OFWs are set to return to the Philippines next month. They were supposed to be flown back home last Thursday, September 26, but several international airlines temporarily suspended their flights. Olalia adds some Filipinos are choosing to stay in Lebanon despite the conflict.
Ang natatanggap po namin ayon sa aming libre attaché, minsan pag kinontak na sila at ready na kaming pumunta doon, yung employer ayaw daw pumayag, no? Hindi siya pinapayagan o kung hindi, yung kanyang pasaporte ay ayaw ibigay. Ang aming instruction naman, pumayag man o hindi, basta kagustuhan ng ating worker yan, kukunin at kukunin natin yan. Merong mang pasaporte o wala, basta importante, kasama natin yung ating OFW, patutulungan na nating mapagawa ng mga exit or travel documents.
Fresh from the pages of a spy novel, that's how the National Security Council is describing alleged claims that dismissed Mayor Alice Guo is a Chinese agent. NSC Assistant Director General Jonathan Malaya says they're currently investigating a Chinese fugitive's claims about Guo. In an Al Jazeera documentary, self-confessed Chinese spy Xie Zhejiang claimed Alice Guo is an agent of Beijing's intelligence agency. But Malaya notes that statement may be laced with ulterior motives since he is wanted for his involvement in illegal gambling operations.
We will have to consult with our partner intelligence agencies abroad para mapagtagpi-tagpi natin, para malaman natin ang tunay na dahilan at tunay na personality ni Alice Guo if he is really an agent of the MSS of the PRC. We have to be very careful in determining kung yung mga sinasabi niya ay totoo ba o nandadawit lang siya ng iba to draw attention to his situation. Kasi